In this first lesson we will see the environment of AutoCAD work, the names of the AutoCAD toolbars. What appears before us as soon as we open a new work is this combination of icons. We have it because down here you see the working environment is set. Drafting an annotation. We have two more, we'll get to know them later on in this lesson. Let's start by getting to know this red top icon that if selected presents us with a series of icons representing commands that we know well that allow you to create a new design, to open drawings already made, if necessary, save as, export if necessary or drawing file in other formats and whatnot, from press to utility of drawing where by the way there is the possibility to set the units of the drawing. This red icon is called application button, then, right next to it, there's this other bar. This set of icons, this bar is called quick access toolbar as there are icons that are usually used in all the drawings and this quick access toolbar always remains available even though we change the work area. So if we were to move to example in 3D Basic, where AutoCAD presents a set of mixed icons for 2D and 3D management, you see that the bar is always displayed above. The other working environment is 3D modeling, which groups a series of icons especially for the management of 3D objects of AutoCAD. We instead go back on drafting an annotation, which is the classic environment for 2D drawing. To know another menu that is usually not displayed, we find it by parading this dart that's part of quick access toolbar. Here it is, there is the menu bar. I would always advise keeping it open, this menu bar, because they are AutoCAD 2008 style menu and gives us a chance to always have all the controls at drop-down arrangement. Despite the change of the workspace and takes up little space, but it allows us to quickly find the commands even if we change the workspace, commands that would otherwise need waste a lot of time looking for them through the various menus. So my advice is to always keep it active. This menu bar, in any case we can hide it again. Then we go to meet this ribbon, which is called the multifunction bar. Let's see what it's like. We have tab that is logically groups together icons representing commands for similar typology on objects. In this case we have selected annotate. Here are all the icons and commands representing, for example, the text, the dimension and so on, from the tables, you see. In short, everything related to the management of the project text. We saw the tabs that are here above. Down here we have areas of our ribbon divided by groups or panels, grouped icons in functions of certain operations that we have to do. For example, here in dimensions we have grouped all the commands for managing the dimensions. Obviously the same as far as the text and so on is concerned. Beware of this arrow because if we click on it makes us see further commands. Let's see a little better tab home, draw panel. Here we have additional commands for the design of AutoCAD. Watch out for this one little icon that allows you to stare the list of these commands that otherwise we won't have, because as soon as we move away with the mouse to do any other operation, this curtain disappears. So click to rewind it as default. Another icon that we meet here on the name of panel, moved to the right little icon tilted downwards. By clicking on it, you can view the properties palette. If instead we move into the annotate tab, here we find more. In the text for example, it makes us appear the window of text style to create new styles. In dimensions, the important window for dimension style management and so on. These are the tab and these are the panels contained in the tabs. We can vary its position simply by clicking with the left mouse button and moving according to our needs. We can decide which tab and which panels we want to make it appear inside the ribbon moving. In this gray area, here it's very tight, we can move on this menu. Here is very wide, button right, view tab, here the possibility. Possibly to remove tabs from the display of the ribbon. The ones we're not interested in, as well as moving to the insert tab. And taking us to the gray part, right button, show panels. We can remove the panels of commands we don't care about. For example, in the insert tab not we're interested in panel location, we're taking it down. Let's move on, for example, to annotate, let's assume we're not interested in annotation scaling here. Right button, show panels. And we take it out, we take the tick off. Here we have the possibility to view objects in the windows in various mode, we'll see. All this especially in 3D. As far as 2D is concerned, usually is always set to 2D wireframe. Same thing for the view cube that allows you to move around between the AutoCAD windows. Front, right, top and so on simply by clicking in a cube position. If we work in 2D, the default setting is top. We're moving down here. This is also an important bar, it's the command line where we talk with AutoCAD. Typing the commands we want to use and where AutoCAD always shows us his requests. Depending on the command in use. For example, line control, OK, you can enter from the keyboard. And as you see we can start drawing. And there are, below, all the various options where we can, since the 2013 version, click here to execute the option. Below, we have three tabs representing the various AutoCAD work environments. Model is the classic one where you draw, then there is layout 1 and layout 2. The so-called paper space that allows you to manage printing is the arrangement of objects on the sheet of paper. We will know these situations well in the continuation of this course. We remain on model and finally the last toolbar, what we see below and the status bar where AutoCAD presents. Numerous icons especially for the precision drawing management. We'll get to know all of these icons as we continue this course. For example, here we have the possibility to set up or snaps. Or the anchors, snap, to the remarkable points of the AutoCAD geometry. Other bars that no longer appear in the latest AutoCAD versions are the toolbars that it might be very convenient to have them at your disposal because take up very little space and put always disposition of the instrument very useful for drawing. Now let's see how to recover from command line. Just enter the minus hyphen, and then type toolbar, confirm with enter. Here, we insert the name of the draw toolbar, then confirm again with enter and enter again. Here they are the old and dear toolbars that were available in older versions of AutoCAD. Once this bar appears, we can view the other toolbars by right-clicking on any icon. This, for example, doing exit also toolbar modify. Here she is, in this way, in our project. We always have the controls to modify the drawing here on the side. Even though we go to select other menus in the ribbon. We'll see, in the next lessons of this course, how to perfect an environment of mixed work that could be useful to us for our projects. And finally, for close, this icon that at first glance, for people who start working with AutoCAD, can be intriguing because you always place it in the center of the drawing. Instead it is a fundamental icon because represents the worktop of AutoCAD and here on the Cartesian plane XY that objects are placed. There are two display modes. Here we are in 2D wireframe and we have you see this kind of icon. We'll just move into another view for a moment. If we activate another display mode, for example, conceptual, here the icon becomes colored in the three axes, and not only that, you can select it and move it with the grips. It is essential to use this aux icon, which allows you to position the various AutoCAD worktops in 3D space. See you in the next lesson.